So a lot of my constituents and people started reaching out with your recent meeting that you had last month and are going to have again this next month with the Illinois State Board of Education. And a lot of it dealing with the mask mandates and the vaccine mandates. That's not the issue. The issue that JCAR is taking up is their ability to quickly enforce the pulling of credentials or removing state funding or pulling students off of being able to compete in sports. So this was brought before you guys. Can you give us a little background into what you guys talked about last month, and there's another meeting coming up this next month, and how this plays in with part of the the emergency orders and what you're looking for out of them month?
Sure. So, you know, one of the simple guidelines for do you need to do rules over a topic are the Illinois Administrative Procedures Act says if you have a benefit or a penalty that a state agency is going to give, so you're going to give a license or give a grant or, you know, give something as a benefit, or if you're going to penalize, if you're going to remove a credential, if you're going to remove a certificate or remove funding, those two things need to have specific procedures in place to say what warrants a benefit, right, or what warrants a penalty. The idea is so it's not just one person's whim, you get this, and I'm going to take this away from you.
No, bam, done, right. Out, yeah.
So you need to have a specific criteria in place. What are the process you're going to follow? How do you appeal it? Things like that. So what we have with the State Board of Education is a question about, they have a procedure that is penalizing some school districts or removing certification, removing funding from districts for not complying with an underlying mandate. Now the question is, are they legally entitled to do that, right, outside of administrative rule? It's a penalty. The Administrative Procedures Act would suggest you need to have a administrative rule in place in order to administer a penalty. We call that in the JCAR world, we call that policy outside of rule.
Okay.
So you can't just post a PDF on your website and say that has a force of law, right? So you have to go through this process. And so we've inquired with the State Board of Education to ask them, you're doing this penalty. Justify that to us. How is this not a policy outside of rule?
Right.
How are you, what are your attorneys saying? You know, what does your legal staff say about why you can penalize this without having established an administrative rule and a procedure for doing that through the normally established process?
Because they currently already have a written out procedure for schools, mm-hmm, that if they do or don't follow, you know, whatever it is, and then they have this opportunity, then that opportunity. And so this is one of those challenges of they, in some people's views, jump the gun in implementing some of these penalties to these schools, whether it's a public or a private school. And JCAR got involved and said, essentially, show us how you think you can do that.
That's right. And we have to make those inquiries of state agencies pretty frequently.
Yeah.
Many times an agency will, sometimes they'll take overly broad authority in their rulemaking. Sometimes it might go a little too far. Other times they don't want to put an administrative rule in. They'll try to do something outside of that process. And so this is a regular back and forth. But again, it's one of those ways that we try to be a check and a balance against the executive branch and say, we're trying to defend what the Administrative Procedures Act says. So if you interpret it differently, make that argument to us. But let's have a real discussion about where your authority is and to what extent we have an ability to check that.
So where are things currently at then with ISBE?
So we're awaiting a response from ISBE, and I think prior to our upcoming meeting next week, we're looking for what their legal response is going to be.
Okay. Now, when it comes to public involvement with this, because we've seen on Facebook, we see the emails that go through, and there's the list out of call everybody on JCAR, tell them your thoughts and opinions. Can you talk to me about the public input and the public process of that? Does that weigh into decisions that JCAR is making? Does it help or hurt how you guys go about making those decisions?
We want to engage, allow people the opportunity for public input. That's what the normal rulemaking process does. There's a specific period where public input is guaranteed. There can even be public hearings on certain issues. So those things, are important. We understand that sometimes there are emergency rules that are filed and you don't have the same process, but we're trying to defend the ability for there to be public input. People contacting our offices, I do think it works.
Okay.
Yeah, I think just like any piece of legislation that we're considering or going to be voting on, we know that sometimes there's effective ways to make arguments and ineffective right. ways to make arguments. But I do find that quite a few people, they're thoughtful about it. They're making reasonable points about it. They're bringing up rightful concerns with an issue. And so I do think it matters.
That's great. That's fantastic. Well, Tom, I appreciate you taking the time today. I appreciate your service and work on JCAR. When's that next upcoming meeting?
October 11th.
October 11th, and they can view it online.
That's right.
Which is a fascinating thing if you've never watched it, to watch one of these JCAR meetings go on and actually see the bipartisanship together, working together, asking questions together. It's fascinating. I actually really enjoy it too. Yeah. And if they have questions for you and JCAR, how do they get a hold of you? What's the best way?
Tom@tomdemmer.com.
There you go. Or you can reach out via my website, repchrisboss.com, and we would love to continue the conversation. If you have any of those questions or have more that you'd like to know about JCAR and how this rules works, we'd love to field those and help you guys out however you can. So, Tom, thanks for taking the time and answering some questions for my constituents, and thank you again for your service on JCAR.
You bet. Thanks, Chris.